The big catalyst for protests at the moment in the Middle East was the video that was released, which mocked the Prophet Muhammad. As a result, there was an attack, as you know, on the American embassy in Benghazi in Libya. The ambassador, Christopher Stevens, was murdered. Do you condemn the attack which caused his murder?
Fundamentally, first of all, any action that is provocative, offends the religious thoughts and feelings of any people, we condemn. Likewise, we condemn any type of extremism. Of course, what took place was ugly. Offending the Holy Prophet is quite ugly. This has very little or nothing to do with freedom and freedom of speech. This is the weakness of and the abuse of freedom. And in many places, it is a crime. It shouldn't take place, and I do hope that day will come in which politicians will not seek to offend those whom others hold holy or sanctities. But we also believe that this must also be resolved in a humane atmosphere, in a participatory environment, and we do not like anyone losing their lives or being killed for any reason anywhere in the world.
There are protesters all over the Middle East now threatening the staff of American embassies, threatening to kill them, to behead them. Do you think they should stop?
You see, I cannot determine what people or nations should do, but I do think that extremism gives birth to following and subsequent extremism. Perhaps if the politicians take a better position in the West vis-a-vis offensive words or thoughts or pictures towards what we hold holy, I think conditions will improve.